very good afternoon to all of you. First, I would like to thank Help Library for giving Unani Medicine this platform and all of you who has come to my talk. I hope you will find this talk very informative and interesting. Friends, we all today are amazed by the miracles of modern medicine, modern medical science. We have very sophisticated medical equipments, inventions. We have very developed modalities of surgeries. We have molecular biology, transplantations. But have you ever thought of what's the history of this modern medicine? How the European countries were dealing with diseases before the invention of germ theory or the invention of microscope? Today I am going to introduce to you the father of modern medicine, which is called as Unani medicine. Unfortunately, we all have forgotten regarding this 5,000 years old traditional system of medicine, which has its own identity. Many times it happens when I meet with someone and say that I practice Unani medicine, they say we have never heard of it, or very often they confuse it with Ayurveda. So the objective of my talk today is to introduce to you Unani medicine, and that's why I have divided my presentation into two parts. The first part deals with the history of Unani medicine, and you will find this history very glorious, and I have introduced the scholars of that era who have contributed to modern medicine. They were the founding fathers of today's basic medical science. So let's go to the presentation. Unani is 5,000 years old system of medicine, which is free from side effects, it's natural, it's curative and safe. The first part is the origin and history of development of Unani medicine, and the second part of this presentation is focusing towards the fundamentals of Unani healing art. The father of Unani medicine is this man who's called Hippocrates. You all must have heard of the Hippocratic Oath that is still taken by the doctors, and which is one of the very first drafted code of medical ethics for the medical professional. So he is the man who is the father of Unani medicine. Now Hippocrates was son of Asclepius. Asclepius was considered as medicine in Greece. In that time, it is around 370 BC. If somebody has visited Greece, still there are remnants of the temples which are built for Asclepius. He was considered as god of medicine. Greece in that era, science, medical science and healing was very much practiced by the temples, priests. So here Asclepius was there, his temple were treated as the place of healing. So the all sick people used to visit that temple. Said that Asclepius used to visit them in their dreams and give them the instruction which type of herb or medicine he should take. And people used to take that medicine and got healed themselves. So they used to, as a reward to the Asclepius, they wrote that formulation and gave it to the idols. So that's why the healing science was confined to the religious places of Greece. Every night for 1,000 years, sick and afflicted pilgrims plagued the Grecian temple of Asclepius, and he used to advise them through the dream visitation. These are the remnants of the Asclepians, which is still today in Greece. Yes. I want to share with you a very interesting fact. Now, this is the emblem of ये किस चीज की निशानी है आप लोग जानते होंगे बहुत सालों तक डॉक्टर्स ने रेड क्रॉस को अपनी निशानी के तौर पे लगाते थे अपने साइन बोर्ड पर बट दिस इज रॉन्ग द एम्बलम ऑफ मेडिकल प्रोफेशन इज दिस एंड देयर इज अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग लिंक जो आप लोगों में से आई एम श्योर किसी को नहीं पता होगा यहां पर कि ये जो सिंबल है मेडिकल प्रोफेशन का This is related with Unani medicine. The Asclepius, which is considered as god of medicine, who was the father of Hippocrates, he used to carry a stick in his hand, and it was surrounded by a snake. So snake was the symbol of long life. So this symbol has contributed, this is considered as the emblem of medical profession which is linked with the history of medicine that is the history of Greek medicine and Asclepius This is the Hippocratic Oath. He is the father of both modern medicine and Unani medicine. He has formulated a theory which is the basic foundation of Unani. I'll come to that theory in the second part. There were many Greek scholars who has contributed to the medical science. Like there was Aristotle who was the founder of the basic medical science which is anatomy, Herophilus who was the father of anatomy, Erasistratul was the father of physiology and Descroid who pioneered medical botany. Have you seen the movie 300? It's about ancient Greece. The story relates with the ancient Greek and there were an attack from the outsiders to the Greece. So the Greek has its own history. It was conquered by Rome. There is very famous Greco-Roman wars. So these Greek scholars who have been the founding fathers of the basic medical science of anatomy and physiology. These anatomy and physiology are the basic science for medicine. Now after this Greek decline, the Greek totally conquered by the Romans, After Greek phase, there comes the Romans. Now Gallienus, which is called in Urdu of Galen. History of Unani medicine or modern medicine is divided into three era. The first is the Greece era, then you have the Roman. Greece was conquered by the Roman and this science was transferred to the Romans. Now this man called Galen, he has translated the Greek ancient Greek science into Latin. Now, afterwards, Rome was conquered by the people of the Middle East, Arabia, and the Middle East scholars, they translated these signs into their own language. In Baghdad, centers were made for specially translating these Latin and Greek scriptures into their own language of Persian and Arabic. And this is the golden era of, this was the golden era of Unani medicine. Why this was? Because Islamic empire was expanding, so they translated all the literature into their own language. These are the scholars of the Middle East who has contributed to Unani medicine. Like we have Avicenna, he wrote the book Al-Qanun. He was considered as the prince of physician. And his book, you will be very surprised to hear that Al-Qanun and the books written by these Middle East scholars were taught in the Western medical colleges till the invention of the microscope and their adoption of the germ theory. Jitne bhi Western mein medical schools the, unme in logon ki likhi hui kitabon ko padhaya jata tha. Like Avicenna, we have Al-Zahrawi, Al-Bukasis. He wrote a book on surgery which is called Al-Tasrif. He was considered as chief of all surgeons. He was given this title. By the 19th century, this Islamic empire extended from Atlantic Ocean to the borders of China. Muslim ruled Spain for 700 years but preserved their rich culture and heritage. Islam stressed importance and respect of learning, forbid destruction and tolerance of other religions. There was this man called Razi. He was the expert of psychology and chemistry. He was the first one to distinguish between smallpox and measles. He was the first person to use alcohol as an antiseptic. And he introduced the concept of keeping medical records in hospitals. He has authored more than 250 books, and his most famous book is called Al-Hawi. Then we have these scholars who has wrote various books on Unani medicine. You will still find it very difficult to get all these books into English. Many of them have been translated. There is one famous historian, Campbell, who wrote that the European medical system is Arabian not only in religion but also in its structure. There was the hospital Jindishapur in Baghdad. They were the pioneer of the medical educational institution system. They were the first to get the licensing of the physician and hospital administration. Now, when the Mongols burned Baghdad, they demolished almost most of the Islamic heritage. And when the Islamic empire collapsed, the Unani medicine came to India through the Mughals. So this is the last destination of Unani medicine. It was adopted in India. Today, Unani medicine is one of the alternative Indian system of medicine. But it is very, very different from Ayurveda, because it has totally different history of itself. No, ingredients. I'll come afterwards, because